Welcome to Entrepreneur Sunday. Each week, we spotlight the brightest black entrepreneurs across the country. Tonight's guest knows how to make a statement through her art. Tyler Clark has taken a creative approach to show off her roots, and the idea is turning heads. Tyler Clark, thank you so much for joining us for Entrepreneur Sunday.
Hi, I'm so happy to be here. Thank you for having me.
Well, Tyler, Inspired by Tyler is all about showcasing the beauty of black women, and you use your 3D art to tell your story. I mean, your work speaks for itself. I saw it myself. How'd you get started creating your beautiful designs?
Well, thank you for the wonderful compliment. I actually went to Spelman and Georgia Tech and studied math and mechanical engineering. So I actually don't have like a traditional art background. And art started off as therapy for me. When I was at Georgia Tech, it was very difficult. The program was extremely rigorous and I needed an outlet. And so I really started painting to alleviate that pressure of completing the program. And people would come over and they actually loved my work and wanted it enough to even purchase it. And I was like, oh, well, I actually have a business here. So I graduated, moved to Chicago, got a corporate job, and I was able to really pour more into painting, and my art started going super viral on social media, and that's when I knew I wanted to really build this brand, Inspired by Tyler.
And so I love how you have the natural hair added as a part of your 3D model. Why was it so important to put that on display, especially at a time when so many black women and women of color are now embracing our natural hair?
Yeah, I mean, my hair is very, very thick, and it's a lot to manage. And I think being an engineer as well as an artist, I wanted my artwork to stand out. And since I know I've always struggled with like my hair and the identity associated with it, I wanted to figure out a way that I could blend my love of my hair as well as my art. And so I think that people can see my artwork and then find beauty in themselves, because when you see something that's beautiful, it allows you to be able to identify with it differently.
And your message of using your art to promote self-love, faith, and women's empowerment is inspiring. Why is that so important at a time like this?
Oh my goodness. We've been through so much heartbreak. And I know that like my art is a way to be able to help heal people's hearts. And when I'm creating something, you know, it started off first as my therapy. So now it's turning into something that is also able to help be that therapy for somebody else on the receiving end. And so if I can take all the emotions that I'm feeling and that other people are feeling and put it into a painting and connect it with song and connect it with just my own personal experiences, it's a relief for others as well. And so it's actually helped a lot of people just get through this time, and it's helped me as well.
You left the corporate job, as you mentioned earlier, to start to pursue your passion in art. What roadblocks did you encounter along the way, and what message would you give to other entrepreneurs looking to find their way as well?
Yeah, you know, I didn't expect to leave my job when I did. I used to work for United Airlines, and as you know, the airline industry really struggled due to this pandemic, and they offered voluntary separation packages, and it was, you know, really the most graceful way that I could exit the company. I was doing very well in corporate, and I decided to take the opportunity. Since doing so, my business has taken off, and it's been a lot to manage. I would say some of my biggest challenges really would be like managing people and understanding what direction do I want my business to go in. I find myself having difficult conversations continuously, and I'm such a sweet person, so it can be very difficult for me to have those conversations, but I have to learn, you know, how to really step into being a boss since I don't have one anymore. So, you know, before, someone was telling me what to do and I had to listen all the time, but now I don't have that same direction. So for me, I really need to stay rooted in my faith, because that's a really great guiding compass for me, and just being able to hold my ground, and when I get knocked off my path, not allowing myself to get defeated, but understanding that this is God's way of guiding me.
I love that. I love that. We all know that. And, you know, I just wanted to ask you another question. When you get ready to sit down to create your piece, what comes to mind? How do you get in that space that you can get in to actually create this beautiful art that you have?
Yeah, I, you know, since it started off being something that was therapeutic for me, it always was rooted in pain. So if my heart was aching or if I was struggling with something, and that was when I was able to create some of my best work. But as I'm becoming more healed and healthier emotionally, now I have to kind of paint because it's part of the business. And so I will say that that's been actually more difficult because I'm not painting from the same pain. And so now I'm trying to learn new ways to be able to stay dedicated to the process of creating new artwork, because holding down the corporate side of my job, like the business part of it, right, and then also the creative, is really difficult. So I think for me, it's going to be really important to manage my peace, because when I'm at a more peaceful place or at a place where I'm just ready to kind of like release, then I can create my best work, if that makes sense.
Awesome. Well, lastly, Tyler, where can our viewers purchase your artwork?
Oh, yeah. So I have a website. It's inspiredbytyler.com. You can find me with or without a D at the end of inspire.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Tyler Clark. Best of wishes to you in your business, and thank you for your time today.
Thank you so much for having me.
That's so cool. She literally has twists like mine on her art. So cool. Tyler says she has notebooks, mugs, phone cases, tote bags, you name it. They cost anywhere from $20 to her major art pieces are up in the thousands. You can also find her art on Instagram and Facebook at Inspired by Tyler as well.